Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss some objective type questions on surface tension. Here question number 1 is, surface tension of a liquid is due to gravitational force between molecules, electrical force between molecules, adhesive force between molecules or cohesive force between molecules. Actually the surface tension of a liquid is due to the force of attraction between similar molecules, or you can say like molecules of a liquid. So the force of attraction between like or similar molecules is called as your cohesive force or force of cohesion. So option D. Next, a liquid drop tends to assume a spherical shape because of the surface tension force, the viscous force, the gravity effect, the elastic force. It is due to surface tension. Option number A. The excess of pressure inside a soft bubble is inversely proportional to surface tension, directly proportional to surface tension, directly proportional to its radius, or inversely proportional to its radius. Excess pressure inside a soft bubble is P is how much? 4S upon R. That is, pressure is directly proportional to surface tension and inversely proportional to R, that is radius. So your option B, directly proportional to surface tension, it is correct, and also option D, inversely proportional to its radius. So you may add another option, option E, that is both B and D. So option E is your correct answer. Next, two water droplets merge with each other to form a larger droplet. In this process, energy is liberated, energy is absorbed, energy is neither liberated nor absorbed, some mass is converted into energy. When two water droplets merge together to form a single drop, then surface area of the larger drop will decrease. Due to which the energy of bigger drop is less than the sum of the energy of two smaller drops. Okay, the energy of the bigger drop is less than the sum of the energy of two smaller drops, for which the energy is released. So here option A, that is energy is liberated. The meniscus of mercury in a capillary tube is convex, concave, plane or uncertain. It is convex, as the angle of contact of mercury and glass is here obtuse angle, that is angle greater than 90 degree. Okay, next question is, here a drop of oil is placed on the surface of water. Which of the following statements is correct? It will remain on it as a sphere, it will spread as a thin layer, it will partly be a spherical droplet and partly a thin film, it will float as a distorted drop on the water surface. The surface tension of oil is less than that of water, so the oil spreads as a thin layer. So option B is your correct answer. Next, two soft bubbles separate in the ratio of 2:1. What is the ratio of excess pressure inside them? Excess pressure inside a soap bubble is how much? Here P is equal to 4S upon R. Here ratio of radius is given. Let R1 is to R2. Or you may say R1 upon R2 is equal to how much? 2:1. Yes. So here P1 upon P2 is how much? 4S. Upon R1, 4S upon R2, that is equal to R2 upon R1, or is equal to 1 upon 2. Or you may say P1:P2 is how much? 1:2. So option A is your correct answer. Next, a given mass of a metal is molded into solids of different shapes. Its surface area is the least when it is a sphere, a right circular cylinder, a paraboloid, a right circular cone. For a given mass, a sphere has the least surface area. So it is option A. Next, which graph represents the variation of surface tension with temperature over small temperature ranges of water? Over small temperature range, surface tension of water decreases linearly with rise of temperature. So from these four graphs, your option B is your correct answer. As your surface tension decreases linearly with increase of temperature. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.